People that India Dhamma Trust is trying to help are the so-called untouchables, or better, the Dalits, or even better, the new Buddhists. So these are the people right at the bottom of the Indian caste system, economically, but also in terms of their very status in society, are really oppressed. And for them, Buddhism has been just a whole new identity and path for transformation out of that oppression. So we're really glad to support the Indian ordination teams. It's very significant the impact that the order members can have in India. There's a really big impact just through how they're living their lives. Of course, all order members take the 10 precepts, and that's really significant. But also, of course, they're able to teach meditation and to pass on the teachings of Buddhism, the wisdom of the Buddha, which changes people's lives for the better. And of course, people see that, and they want that. And they particularly want that because Dr. Ambedkar advised them that that was what they needed. And there's an incredible faith in the Dalit or new Buddhist community towards Dr. Ambedkar. There's now a public preceptor, an Indian Dhammacharini is a public preceptor, Jnanashuri, who was actually present at Dr. Ambedkar's conversion in 1956. He was a young child.
चौदा ऑक्टोबरला दीक्षा होती तर 13 ऑक्टोबरचं मी सांगत आहे 13 ऑक्टोबरला म्हणजे सगळ्या महाराष्ट्रातून खूप मोठ्या प्रमाणात लोक तिथे आलेले होते सकाळी 14 तारखेला सकाळी साधारणतः 6:30 ला आम्ही मोर्चाने तिकडे जायला सगळे लोकांवस्तीतले लोक मिळून आम्ही जायला निघालो आणि मग म्हणजे आपल्या इथल्या भारतीय पद्धतीप्रमाणे एका बाजूला महिला बसल्या होत्या एका बाजूने पुरुष बसले होते आणि मी तसं म्हटलं तर खूप लक्की आहे की मी समोर बसले होते आणि खूप आनंदाने तिथपर्यंत लोक जात होते आणि जेव्हा आम्ही तिथे पोचलो तर तो 14 एकराचा जो दीक्षाभूमीचा परिसर होता तो पूर्ण भरून गेलेला होता कारण काही लोक तिथेच मुक्कामाला होते म्हणजे मला तेव्हा एवढं जाणवत होतं की आता आम्ही हिंदू धर्म सोडणार आहोत आणि खूप काहीतरी चांगलं बुद्ध धर्मामध्ये आम्हाला मिळणार आहे एवढंच त्यावेळी मला समजत होतं
Dalit women in India face a sort of double discrimination, if you like, being both Dalit, of course, and because of their gender. So there's very little freedom to, for example, get an education or one's own livelihood. What's been really delightful to see increasingly over the years are the number of new Buddhist women who are getting a kind of personal, economic and social independence in their lives. And some are even choosing not to get married and have a family and actually be full-time Dharma workers. And that's a real boon for the women Sangha because, of course, then there are women who are able to travel around, teach the Dharma, work in retreat centers and so forth.
I work for Aryatara Mahila Trust, which is based in Pune. And the project I'm working, that name is Maji Asmita. And the English meaning of that is my dignity. Because in India, the women's situation is very different than any other places. These women in Rajasthan and Gujarat, they are much behind than us. I would say they are 40 years behind than us, what situation they are having there. They don't have any education, totally means fully illiterate women are there. They don't have any of the good facility in their life. They don't have any toilets, any bathrooms in their houses. And we stay 3 days in one village. One day we are teaching them the Buddhism and the meditation, the Metta Bhavana. And the 2 other days, we go house to house and do a lot of home visits. So we are talking with the whole family. And at the same time, we are working with the schools also. There are children who has admitted in the school, but they never turn to the school. So we try to go to their houses and try to motivate those children and their parents also to send them to the school.
The thing I think that is such an unusual thing is the idea of women working together for women. So one of the things that the ordination team do a great deal of is developing Kalyana Mitrata, because that's an unusual thing. You have families for that in India. You don't have other people to whom you are not biologically related or related by marriage. And so the idea of building Kalyana Mitrata is quite challenging, I think, in some ways. But it's one of the things that changes women's view, the idea that you work together with other women on a project that's not for your family.
Because my grandfather, my parents were follow the Dr. Ambedkar, what he suggested to do first is education. So they were so poor. My grandfather was very poor. They were, you know, having first education and then later on food. So there is food is secondary things, but education is very important. So they got this all struggle. But we, as a maybe third generation, as my third generation was get good benefits of that. But I don't want it to be stay in that benefits and indulge, you know, in that benefit. I wanted to do something kind of work. So many thousand people are, you know, still suffering, still need some kind of guidance, kind of they are in confused state. They don't know what to do in their life. And when I saw this suffering, I thought I like to do this work. And I like to keep a little bit from my life. Yeah.
Now I am doing not different from my professional things, not as a doctor, but as a helping, as a social helper. Like I want to help those people who are like my past. Oh, sorry. So I'm doing for those girls who are bright like me and who can do their future brighter like me, and then they can help me like I'm helping to the other poor people.